gain advantage, they will do those things. So subtle. These are counterfeit teachers who subtly targeting people who are easily prayed for lack of knowledge of truth. The secret? You have to grow in the truth, in the word of God. Okay? They are so knowledgeable of the truth, but fails to submit it. Sabi ng verse, sabi po ni Paul, always learning but never able to acknowledge the truth. Laging nag-aaral pero hindi naman talaga sinusubo yung sarili doon sa katotohanan na kanyang pinag-aaralan. Ayan. Always learning but never able to acknowledge the truth. Iba sobrang lalim pero simple magpatawad, hindi magawa. Ang lalim na lang pinag-aaralan mo nila pero sobrang patawarin mo kapatid, hindi magawa. Sobrang lalim na po yun. Watch out. Pakisabi sa katabi mo, kumising pa yan, mag-ingat ka katabi. Mag-ingat ka. Also, people who have meaningless faith, they imitate the truth but opposes God's servant. Paul uses a classic example. Sabi niya, Jannes, just as Jannes and Jambres opposed Moses, so also these men opposed the truth. Men of depraved minds, who as far as the faith is concerned, are rejected. Paul mentioned two persons, Jannes and Jambres. Ang tawag po natin, si JJ. Sino po yan si JJ? Sila po yung mga magicians nung time na gumagawa si Moses ng mga himala sa panahon ni Pharaoh. Remember? The plague? Okay, pag humasin, sabi ng Lord, oh, magpalabas ka ng mga palaka. Ang pagkakayain nila, magpapalabas nila ng palaka. Ang problema na, superior yung kapangyarihan ng Diyos. Kakainin yung palaka na ginawa ngayon ni Jannes and Jambres. So, anong trabaho ni Jannes and Jambres? They are magicians, counterfeit, duplicating the truth of the power of God. Marami po na niya yung mga kapatid. They are trying to duplicate, counterfeit naman, with the purpose of opposing the men of God. Pero the will of God says, their faith is rejected. They are not true servant of God. Marami po itong binanggit mga kapatid. Why am I mentioning this? So negative, parang napakabigat. Sometimes we need to hear this because we need to be aware of what is happening now and what will happen in the future. Are we to be alarmed? No. We just need to be aware. We just need to be aware. And at the same time, be reflective. Am I guilty of this? Am I already going that way, that path? But tayan po natin mga kapatid. Am I lover of myself already? Ang iniisip ko na lang ba sarili ko? Am I pursuing wealth more than God? We need to check ourselves. Have you noticed? Let me close this first point. Have you noticed that Paul doesn't talk about much of the persecutions? But he talk about more of the temptations that any person will receive at the end times while this world is worsening. Pansinin niyo po, ang pinupunto ni Pablo ay yung mga tukso na dadaanan ng tao. Tukso saan? Sa kayamanan, tukso sa pagmamahal sa sarili, pagiging mayaman, conceited, rash. Pero hindi niya sinasabing pinag-usapan yung marami tungkol sa pagsubok na tatanggapin nila. You know why? Because even Paul knew that persecution is not natural, but it is not a strong weapon of the enemy more than temptations. Totoo po yun. A stronger weapon of the enemy is not persecution, but temptation. Because in the last days, people will be persecuted in their faith, but they will be able to stand. But when Christians are tempted, eto maganda kay, eto gusto ni Satanas. Kasi yung mga Kristiyano, I don't know, ang mga Kristiyano, we have a saying, when the going gets tough, the tough gets going. Kung totoong anak ng Diyos yan, at Kristiyano, habang umihirap ang laban, lalo nagpupusigi. Yan ang totoong Kristiyano. Habang pinipigil, lalo nanggigigil. Ito ang mga Kristiyano. Habang humihirap, nagpapatuloyan. Pero ang problema sa Kristiyano, if you are just going to provide them a little comfort for now, masasanay sila sa comfort na yun. And later on, it's hard for them to go out and escape that comfort zone. Totoo po yan. The good thing about me playing my sports ping pong, alam niyo, sa character sa ping pong na na-develop and I like so much is that kapag humihirap yung laban, you don't give up. You stick and think and focus some more. The last tournament that I went to, after immediately after my vacation, pag-uwi ko sa Pilipinas, I joined a national tournament. For the first time, I joined a tournament for 2 days until 4 o'clock in the morning. Naglalaro pa ho yung mga manlalaro. Can you imagine yung hirap? Migraine, gutom. But the character is being built to persevere, pursue in times of testing. Pero ang Kristiyano, mga kapatid, ang loopholes niya is that ang binigyan siya ng tukso ng kaaway, ng comfort, and little pleasure. Let me ask you, who are those of you who came from Saudi Arabia? Pakitas na po ng kamay. Okay? Anong mas mahirap na lugar? Ang Saudi o tayo? Alam na natin yan. Yung Saudi. Tanong, saan mas madalas umabsent sa church? Sa Saudi o dito? Sa UAE. Kasi may basketball pa kayo mamaya. Why? Pagbukas sa pleasure, ang dali mong bumigay. Pero the more na mahirap ang sitwasyon, the church, you go back and study the church. The more the church was persecuted, the more they spread, the more they grow. Because the blood of the martyrs becomes the seed of the church. Kaya hindi po natatakot ang Kristiyano na darating, ma'am, paano kayong contribution? Paano tayo kayo pag pumasok ang mga ganito? Anong gagawin sa atin? Hindi ako kinatatakutan niya, mga kapatid. So that's why I believe that when Christ comes, it's after the tribulation. The church will go through the tribulation. But take heed, I have overcome the world through the Lord Jesus Christ. Hindi takot ang Kristiyano pagdating ng panahon na yun. Kasi they will try. Jesus already overcome the world. We have sung it already. Pero ang Kristiyano mabibiktima sa mga simpleng tukso na ibibigay sa Tagas. Come on, pagod kayo. Pigit mo lang ng konti mata mo. Paano mo makapagpahinga ka? Wala nang makikira kung humihingi ka dyan sa ubuhan mo. Just a little comfort. Di ba? Ang sarap eh. Pag nasanay ka na, that's why Paul was very careful. Do not give the devil a foothold. An inch. Because he will take you in a mile. Ilalayo ka niya. That's the danger of temptations. That's why Paul was mentioning about temptations, not more on persecutions. Although, later on, he's not going to share about this persecution, the persecution that he received. Matthew chapter 24, verse 12, because of the increase of wickedness, the love of most will grow cold. Sasama ang mundo, maraming tukso. Lalala ang takbo ng mundo, maraming tukso. At dahil dyan, maraming manlalamig sa pag-ibig nila sa Panginoon. Again, pakigisin niya kapagin para sabi, kumusta na ang pag-ibig mo sa Panginoon kapagin? Kumusta na? Mainit pa ba yan? O nag-iiyan na? Secondly, let me end with this. We are in a troubled times, in a worsening world. Now let's talk about the inspiration that we have in a worsening world. Where do we get our strength in this kind of situation? Where do we get our inspiration? First, sabi ni Paul in verse 10 to 15, let me read this to you. Paul again says, you, however, know all about my teaching, my way of life, my purpose, my faith, patience, love, endurance, persecution, sufferings, what kind of things happened to me in Antioch, Iconium, and Lystra. The persecutions I endured, yet the Lord rescued me from all of them. You see, our inspiration is that, mga kapatid, kaya hindi tayo kailangan matakot. The world may turn upside down, But we can be sustained and we can be steadfast because there are people who have gone ahead of us. There are people who have really overcome this kind of situation. And Paul is one of them. That's why we get our inspiration from the influence of God's workers. Like Paul, he's Timothy's mentor. Okay? Another is that not only his mentor, but also from his mothers. Sabi ni Paul sa kanya, okay? Verse 14. But as for you, continue in what you have learned and become convinced of, because you know that those from whom you have learned it, and how from infancy you have known the Holy Scripture. Alam niyo po, maganda kay Timothy, bata pa lang po siya, tinuruan na siya ng kanyang nanay tungkol sa salita ng Diyos. Kaya kahit sumasama ang mundo, sabi ni Paul, remain, continue with what you have learned from your mothers. Sige mother niya, chapter 1 verse 5 will tell you, it was Eunice and Louis. Yung kanyang nanay at yung kanyang lola, tinuruan na siya bata pa lang ng salita ng Diyos. That's why I encourage you, parents, please don't stop teaching your kids about the Word of God. The man standing before you is a man who was taught as an early age about the Word of God. If I can only find that woman who taught me the Bible through my Sunday school, wala na akong estudyante, ako na lang, tinuturuan pa niya ako mag-isa. One woman na lang kami, hindi mo siya sumuko. And I'll never forget that woman. Kahit hindi ko siya nakikita. Because they, sabi ni Paul, they will remain on that when they grow old. Okay? So, you will be an inspiration sa mga susunod sa inyo mana. Ikalawa, our inspiration comes from the instruction of God's Word. Sabi ng talata 16, we've read it again. All Scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness. The word God-breathed means inspired by God, meaning that the Bible comes directly from the Lord. It is breathed out from God, of God, okay, by the Holy Spirit. Although tao pong sumulat ng Biblia, pero binabayan ng Banal na Espiritu para na sa ganun, hindi magkamali ang tao. Okay? Ang tawag po doon ay inspiration. The Bible was written by men but inspired by the Holy Spirit. Kaya naman, the Bible has received all kinds of persecution. From the start until now, it was scrutinized, persecuted, and yet it remains in our hands today. Why? Because it came from God. Sabi ng isang lalaking matalino by the name of Gamaliel, Gamaliel is a Pharisee, pinahinto ng mga Pariseo, yung mga alagad ng Diyos na mangaral. Sabi ni Gamaliel, wow, ito pong sabi niya, because if it is from God, you will not be able to stop this man. You will only find yourselves fighting against God. If the Word of God, if the Bible is from God, no one can stop. Amen po ba? That's why until now, it is in our hands. Kahit marami na akong nagbanta para sulugin yan, pigilan yan. In fact, sa Moscow mga kapatid, nagkaroon pa sila ng museum na kung saan yung mga articles was designed just to fight against the Bible to stop it. But until now, it isn't going. Okay? Si Voltaire, known to be in this world as the one an atheist, fight against the Bible through his printing press. Sabi niya, as long as I live, my printing press will be used to fight against the Bible until I see the last page of that destroyed. What happened? He died. And later on, his printing press was used to print the Bible. Kaya nga sabi mo ng isang lalaki by the name of Bernard Graham, no other book has been chopped, knifed, and scrutinized than the Bible, and yet it survived until now. Why? It is from God. It is inspired by God. The Bible is our inspiration for this time and times because it is the source of our sound belief. Okay. The grass withers and the flower falls away, but the word of the Lord endures forever. Lilipas tayo mga kapatid, pero hindi ang salita ng Diyos. Amen po ba? Mawawala tayong lahat, pero mananatili ang salita ng Diyos. The Apostle Paul is writing to Timothy that he can stay on course in this world that is off track as long as he keeps on his feet on the Word of God. We need to learn how to keep our track to the Word of God. Sa research ni George Barna, isang Christian researcher, natutasan niya. Gusto niya malaman gaano paalam ang mga tao sa salita ng Diyos. Ito po ang findings niya. Nagbigay siya ng konting, sa out of 10 tao, kunyari, nagbigay siya ng examination. I-arrange niyo na, kindly arrange this group of people. Abraham, Moses, David, Daniel. Okay? Ayusin niyo sila kung sino naong nasakla sa Bible. Alam niyo po, mula doon sa 10, wala pa sa kalahati ang nakapag-ayos ng tama. Una si Abraham, si Moses, si David, at si Daniel. Yung babaligtan na. Again, tinanong niya, sino si Matthew? Okay? Konti lang sa kanilang, 1/10 lang sa 10 ang nagsabi, siya ay isang alagad ng Diyos sa bagong dipan. Mula doon sa 10 na sinerve niya, isa lang mula doon sa 10 ang nagsabing siya'y gumagawa ng desisyon ng prinsipyo ang batayan ay ang salita ng Diyos. Ito ang pinakamasaya, mga kapatid. Sabi niya, kindly put your special, your memory verse, the only memory verse you know sa Biblia. Alam niyo ang nilagay niya, mga kapatid? The most of the 10 na naglagay ng kanyang memory verse na naalala nila is that this verse, God helps those who help themselves. Yung daw yung memory verse nila. Alam mo ba wala sa Bible nila? Ganun po ka walang kaalaman sa salita ng Diyos ang maraming tao. Mga kapatid, we need to grow in the Word of God. Let me end on this. He is our source of sound behavior. He is also the source of our sanctified behavior. Sound belief and sanctified behavior. Sabi ni Paul, God-breathed, useful for teaching, correcting, rebuking, and training in righteousness. Training in righteousness. The scripture teaches that true spirituality necessitates a balance between belief and behavior. It involves knowledge, both the head and the heart. Huwag po tayo magkamali. Dapat balance. Both the head and the heart. Knowledge and experience. Kapag po panailaman lang ng utak natin at lumulog yan, yabang ang mangyayari. Pag naman puro puso, experience lang lahat yan. Minsan, wala ka na sa alignment. The world has an overloaded information because of information technology. But what people need is transformation, and the Word of God was given not just to inform us, but to transform us. As Charles Swindoll says, new articles may inform us, novels may amaze us, poetry may inspire us, but only the living Word of God can transform us. Amen po ba? Ano kaibahan ng Biblia sa ibang libro? Pwede maging marunong ka sa libro na iba. Pero ang tanging makapagbabago ng buhay mo ay ang salita ng Diyos. Natanong niyo ba kung bakit pasama na pasama ang mundo? Totoo, dahil nakahula sa Biblia. Hindi lang po. Because Satan is doubling his time to take as many as he can with him in hell. Inadamay niya ang anak natin. Pwede hindi niya makibigan ng mga Kristiyano, mga kapatid. O pwede hindi niya maisama ng mga Kristiyano sapagkat sila yung kasama na ni Kristo. Pero pwede niyang pigilan sila na huwag sumunod sa kalooban ng Diyos. Let me quote our theme verse for this year. And let's read it all together. The world and its dark desires passes away, but the man who does the will of God lives forever. Masisira ang mundo at sasama, pero nananatili sa kalooban ng Diyos ay magpapatuloy magpakailanman. Amen po ba? Pwede mo pakisabi sa katabi mo, kasama ka doon kapatid. Aming Diyos na makapangyarihan sa lahat, we praise you and thank you for this word, reminding us, Lord, that indeed, it is only your word that will be our ground to stand this worsening world. Again, we pray that you will protect us continually from the schemes of the enemy that will try to stop us and even intimidate us, O God, to pursue your will. But knowing that you have already overcome the world, we will persevere and endure because we have you and we love you. Thank you, God, and seal this word now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Let's prepare our hearts for our Lord's Supper. Ganda po natin ating mga sarili sa banal na hapunan. And we're inviting yung mga kapatiran, kung kayo may personal na relasyon sa Panginoon, nasa inyong pag-ibig ng Diyos, ay maaari po kayo makibahagi sa banal na hapunan at ito yung pag-aalala ng kanyang pagmamahal sa atin. bread. After giving thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body which is offered for you. Take it in remembrance of me." Thank you.
Thank you. Once again, if you have the Philippine Evangelical Christian Church, we would like to welcome everybody, especially our friends and visitors who attend our service for the first time. And as we call your name, we would like to ask you to please stand to acknowledge your presence this afternoon. And also, don't be surprised that somebody will approach you and invite you in our prayer room to share with you some souvenir items coming from our church. In our midst, would like to welcome Marquis Madera. We also would like to welcome Kalit Kapiluda. And also would like to welcome Vincel Piniguina. Also, we'd like to welcome Corazon Rivera. Welcome. Also, we'd like to welcome Camille Soyo. Welcome. Lastly, but not least, we'd like to welcome Crystal J. Of course, we'd like to welcome our beloved pastor. Welcome back, Pastor Robert. Also, we'd like to welcome the Spiritus family, Brother Jonathan and Sister Sandra. As for our announcement, serving next week, we would like to remind those people who will be serving next week, our preacher, our pastor, Pastor Robert Tibot, our presider, Elder Brother Gabriel De Leon, song leader will be Sister Veronica Barba, tithes and offering Brother Marvin and Sister Gina Albino Jr., prayer intercessor Brother Martin Guzman, Sister Joy Guzman, and Sister Dale Magsino. Also, reminder, our fellowship in church. Thank you po, ang fellowship in church po natin sa hapong ito will be the Jahili G Group. And would like to congratulate the Jahili G Group on the occasion of their 4th G Group anniversary. Ang Jahili G Group po for the permission, everybody. Ito din po ang tinatawag na Veterans Group. Kaya, meaningful ang kailang celebration kahapon at nakalamig na doon sila sa ano kami sa Bubas Harapan having a camping night. And also would like to announce na meron pong praise and worship spiritual retreat and outing the next Friday, next Saturday, not this coming Saturday, that will be next Saturday. And I would like to ask Brother Conrad to give us the details of the program.
We would like to invite everyone sa mga masabi sa Saturday, next Saturday, para i-hold ang aming first retreat for 2016. It will be a family day for us kung sasama kayo. And then kung gusto nyo magpa-register, punta lang kayo sa mga magaganda namin kasama, kay Raquel, kay Clarice, and then kay Olin. Para register kayo para maka-claim kayo ng 75, including na po yung food, saka yung sayo ko. Then, 75 ang adult, 50 ang bata. Okay? So kung gusto niyo sumama, pero yung payment, kahit ito na lang, para at least wala tayong handle, para wala tayong responsible. So, pa-register na kayo para ma-avail natin yung 75 para do, 50 ang bata. Ang bata is, I think, 12 below or 11 below. Okay, pa-register lang sa tatlo. Thank you.
Thank you, Brother Conrad. And also, there will be a CYP meet and greet on March 11 at 7 evening at Bawani Mall. Brother Bo will give us some details also with this program with this week.
Pahabol po sa mga CYA age 18 to 39. Lahat po na mga singles, lalaki, babae. Magkaroon po tayo na in behalf of our chair, Sis Juan, Sis Juana. Siya po ating chairman sa CYA. 18 po hanggang 39, magkaroon po tayo ng meet and greet. Mayroon po tayong bowling tournament. Marami po tayong mga prizes, so huwag po kayo mawala. Invited din po mag-join ang youth. Kung sino po ang gusto sa youth, pwede po mag-join next week. March 11 po, Bawani Mall, 7:30.
Thank you.
Thank you, Brother Bo. And also, we have a special invitation. It's coming Friday. Our brother Jansen and Sister Mitch, they are inviting everybody sa kanilang Child Education Academy. That will be this coming Friday, right after our worship service. Salamat po, kapatid, sa invitation po. At the fellowship center po ito, sa bahay ni Pastor, right after our worship service. Okay? And also, reminder, fellowship in church, next week, will be the Kalipa G Group. Kalipa G Group will be the fellowship in church. And also, we'd like to invite everybody sa prayer meeting po natin every Sunday. We would like to invite everybody a prayer meeting every Sunday at 7:30 in the evening at the Fellowship Center sa bahay ni Kuyang Pastor. And also, we have also to remind that there will be council meeting, patient council meeting, that will be on March 11. The morning, the fellowship center, attention, council meeting. So, it will be on March 11 at the fellowship center. Yes, please pray at the Baga. And also, we have tonight, men's basketball game. Mga Pilipino, mga kalakihan po natin sa ating church will be having a basketball game tonight. And they are also inviting everybody to watch this game. And also, pray for them. Kasi na ipanato. At ang gusto ninyo kumuha ng t-shirt, if you want to avail this t-shirt, itong uniform ng mga uniform ng basketball natin, basketball uniform, just approach Brother June, Brother Raymond, and Brother Marvin. Anong ninyo ko sila? Magkano po ang presyo nito? Okay? So, we have no more announcement. This is all stand for our prayer and benediction that will be given to us by the Lord Pastor.
We thank the Lord for the success of ating Marcania G Group celebration last Friday. At ngayon po yung ating Jahili Group, G Group. Let's pray for them. Apat na taon pa lang po sila. Wala ko sa mukha nila talaga yan. We praise the Lord. Have you noticed, ano po, different DG groups has different celebration of their own. And we praise the Lord for that. Yun po yung ilang mga desire, plano nila. Kaya nagpapasalamat tayo sapagkat dito po sa FECC, we open for that. And there's no competition. We would like that every G group to grow. So, ano po plano nila, baka sa susunod, sa mga cruise naman sila mag-celebrate. Kayo po, kung anong gusto nyo sa G group nila, baka yung ikunan niya. So, panalangin po natin ang ating mga G-Groups. Let's pray, let's come to the Lord, and ask the Lord's blessing. Father, we thank you again. The world may be indeed worsening and believe in a perilous time, and yet, we thank you that we can be unshakable and stand firm, knowing that we have you, and we have your word that will keep us, oh God, aware of what's happening, and not to be victimized, but by the enemy and his schemes. We ask right now, Lord, that you will continue to be with us and bless us wherever we go, in our work, in our school, even in our own homes. I pray that you will make us prosperous in our work, and that we can be also a blessing to others who have not known you yet as their personal Lord and Savior. We pray that our lives will be indeed a light and salt to them, and that we can really show them the difference between the world of this the people of this world and the people that you have, O God, have called up as your church. We pray that you will empower us continually, and that our lives will be a blessing to many. We thank you and keep us safe as we go out from this place. We pray that you will bless our different G groups who are celebrating their anniversaries. We ask that you will use them, O God, to reach out for our souls, that they can bring into your kingdom. We thank you for their lives. We thank you, Lord, for the interest that you have given to them through their fellowship, through the Bible studies that they're doing, they're conducting. Many are coming to you and knowing you as their personal Lord and Savior. So we ask that you use them mightily wherever, O God, they conduct these Bible studies. We thank you, Lord, and we just commit them to you. We ask that you will be with us continually wherever we go. We praise you, and we just bring back all the honor to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.